Nestled in South Canterbury between Timaru and Fairlie is the town of Pleasant Point, a place you might just drive through. But it has a special piece of history that draws people from far and wide. Katie Stevenson went to visit.
Stoking the firebox before a final once-over to get this magnificent steam train rolling down the track.
You've got to light the fire, boil I don't know how many thousand litres of water to get a bit of steam pressure up. So we go through a lot of wood to do that.
The Pleasant Point Museum and Railway's been operating for over 50 years.
None of this was here. We had to lay track. We got it from here, there and everywhere. And it was a major job putting the track down. This building we put up ourselves.
This steam engine was destined for the scrap heap after the Fairlie branch line closed in 1968. But after a restoration, it's found a home here as a tourist attraction.
We had no idea that we were ever going to run it. Then the guy who was in charge decided we'll see if it goes. And the water shot out like a fire brigade's hose, and the steam going up, very, very impressive.
There are only four of this class of steam trains still operating in New Zealand. This one is 100 years old. It operates at least 17 times a year and is a major draw card for the town.
I feel that a lot of people have come to Pleasant Point to see the museum who wouldn't normally come. They go straight down State Highway 1.
I think the thought of seeing a 85-tonne steam engine and steam. A lot of people who come don't remember the days of steam on New Zealand railways.
There's a second engine here too, plus one of the world's only Model T Ford rail cars. It's not just big trains on show. This model railway, a labour of love.
I was given a German set to play with, because my older brothers weren't interested in it. And I've been model railwaying ever since. It was a pleasure to take over the layout.
The upstairs cinema has a classic offering.
On a Saturday night, we have like the pictures used to have, a God Save the King or Queen, and then we have a newsreel and a sort of a documentary, and then a main feature, you know, at half-time, we have trumpet ice creams at half-time.
But the volunteers that run the place are looking for a new generation to keep it on track.
Maybe we'll use this as a recruitment drive,
yes,
get some
please.
More people.
Yes, please, definitely.
So this iconic enterprise stays full steam ahead. Katie Stevenson, One News.